that's 360 degrees, so if I'm not looking at you, please do not take it the wrong way. But a big welcome from my side to this crucial launch, and obviously being here in Silicon Valley with all the technology in our cars, the lifestyle of our brand, I think it's very appropriate to be here. And Joe, congratulations for executing this great event. And Joe is in a very unfortunate position, since I have a minor PR background. Basically, everything he does gets second and triple guessed, and he's the best guy in the business, and I appreciate everything he's doing. So with that, let's jump into the A3 and the whole focus for our year. And the first thing I want to start is, before we plunge into the product, I think it's one thing to launch a product. I think the more important thing is your brand ready for this product. And I think many of you know this because we've been telling this story for a number of years. The Audi of today is dramatically different from the Audi just a couple of years ago. As you know, our product portfolio is relatively limited, and we had this nasty problem of charging low prices and having very high incentives on our cars. Not a good business model for the US market. Our reputation wasn't as strong as it could be, and of course, many of our dealer partners manifested a similar representation in the marketplace. It really wasn't premium, it really wasn't tier one. I think if you fast forward to today, it's been dramatic what you see. GFK, which is an important brand measurement that we look at, had us at the end of last year number one in consideration amongst all luxury brands. If you look at some of the most reported and trusted brands in the United States, this is all brands, obviously not just automotive. We're in the top 50, which is fantastic. We've raised our transaction prices. Your average Audi goes out the door at around $52,000. It was just 3 or 4 years ago, your average Audi went out the door at $42,000. This means we're selling a lot more A8s, A7s, A6s, and a higher mix of tech packages in our cars. The good news is we're getting the pricing. We also have some of the lowest incentives in the business. And really, what we're extremely proud of, and you've all seen this in consumer reports, you know, when you look at this reputation, nothing says reputation. We're the top European brand and the third best brand in consumer reports. It speaks to the quality, it speaks to everything you're doing. The reason I say this is a lot of brands launch products, they see sales growth come from those products. What we've always stressed is you need a brand, you need a business plan. We don't want to just go up for a couple of months, we don't want to go up for a year or two, we want to climb the mountain and we want to stay at the top of the mountain. And the best way to do that is to make sure your brand and your network is ready for what's coming. So now, what exactly is coming? If you look at the premium market overall, between now and 2018, 2020, it's going to be growing at around 30%. And there's a couple of dynamics here. One, there is going to be more luxury sales, but also we see the percent of luxury of total market going up as well. And certainly products like you see outside are driving a little bit of that. But we also know what we call this premium A segment is going to be growing by 400%. It is by far the fastest growing segment that we have out there. If you look at the sedan segment, it's going to be adding nearly 75,000 units over the next couple of years. It's a crucial thing because we know very well both sides of the coin. If you get to a segment a little bit late and you're there in the third and fourth generation of cars, it's very difficult to get buyers out of brands in the luxury segment. That's why we want to jump in early, we want to jump in all in, and we want to own this growing segment now and not wait our turn on this front. So to that point, we feel very confident with what we're bringing to the marketplace. The goal here is to not just put our toe in the water, launch a sedan, and see what happens. As we've announced in LA, and we've told the journalists, we are launching 7 variants, 4 body styles, as you can see here, 5 unique engines. Of course, we're coming with the Sportback, which we've had previously. Of course, the sedan you see outside. Of course, the Cabriolet, which we'll be launching. And then, of course, the SUV Q3, which will be coming later this year. We believe in this segment, and that's why we're pressing our full advantage into the segment. Now, why are we heading here, and what's the demographic that's making this thing happen? I think there's, again, a couple of dynamics. First and foremost, we are the number one brand right now today in terms of attracting Gen X and Gen Y buyers to our brand. I don't think it's a surprise. If you look at what Audi is, it's high design, it's high technology, it's a brand that's of the times. That's what Gen X and Gen Y looks for. That's exactly what our products bring to the marketplace. We're number one, millennials, and of course we have a broad portfolio as our gift reference, which is going to draw this attraction. The other thing I think you'll see about this car, and this is what we're most proud of, is what most people do here is they say, let's take our powerful brand, water it down by around 400%, and lo launched a cheap car. This has absolutely nothing to do with launching a cheap car. This thing is a full-blown Audi from start to finish. Tons of the technology you see here comes from our A8. The car is built like an Audi, drives like an Audi, performs like an Audi, and has the technological kick of an Audi, because that is what the market demands. We know that's what Gen X and Gen Y wants, and we know that's clearly what we want to bring. I think the other thing that's crucial as you look at this car is we've been here before. This car is about the size of the B5, so going back three generations of our A4. What happened in the B segment is it met consumer taste generation after generation. So the cars got bigger and the cars got more expensive. In our minds, this opened an extremely strong sweet spot for this A3. And as you all know, when that B5 came, 95, 96, that was really the first vehicle that got Audi off its feet from the dark days. That got us here on Earth. This vehicle, A3 now, is going to absolutely take this brand to the moon. The other thing we know is when we had the A3 Sportback on the market, extremely successful car in these creative class communities, Seattle's, Portland's, San Francisco. In fact, we sold nearly 45% of every A3 Sportback in California alone. So this told us something. One, it told us we had a cool car. It told us something that we could take advantage of. But boy, oh boy, it certainly wouldn't hurt if we could put a sedan into the marketplace. This is when we started to hold our conversations with Audi AG. As you know, the Sportback sells extremely, extremely well in Europe. This is not a product they were thinking of from Europe, and it's really the first time, ground zero, that they developed a car for the U.S., a sedan. Something we've been fighting for, something we've been fighting over, and we are extremely thrilled that it's here in the marketplace. And this is a historic moment in time for us to take advantage of this. Now, where does this leave us? I think you all know last year we sold nearly 158,000 cars in America. Just to give you some context, it took us 40 years to break through the 100,000 unit barrier. We did it around 2010. And now, just a few short years later, we broke through 150,000. The mythical milestone, as you all know, is 200,000 units. I feel extremely confident with these products in the marketplace. We're going to get there significantly, significantly sooner than we've been projected. And it's clearly, clearly in sight for us. Now, the other important thing is the other side of the coin. I've told you about the brand, I've told you about the products. I want to spend a little time talking about this network. You know Audi Natick up in Boston, but our dealers, since this brand turnaround, have invested nearly $1 billion in new facilities. And the one thing about dealers, it's not some naive equation that you show on their doorsteps and say, please build a $20 million facility. It would be a really nice thing if you could do it for me today. Not gonna happen. Very simplistic equation. One, do you get the return on sales? Audi has return on sales. The second thing you get is the value of the franchise. And if you look at the multiples and the returns that an Audi franchise is delivering, 7x earnings. This is where Porsche is, this is where Lexus is, this is exactly where an Audi franchise needs to be, and it's exactly where we are, which is dynamic. The other thing, of course, is we currently have in the pipeline 109 active projects. So the dealers are getting ready for the growth that's coming. They're obviously getting ready for the products you're all going to be driving over the next couple of days. And I think this transformation is really driving right here in Silicon Valley. If you look at Audi Stevens Creek, which is a Penske store, this is the number one selling Audi dealership in the country. They did over 2,000 cars last year. So this is a testament to what this brand power has, a testament to what dealers can do, and I feel extremely confident this dealership I'm about to show you on the next stage. We opened this dealership just last week, Audi of Central Houston, 142,000 square feet. 30 lifts, 10 car showroom, without a doubt, mark my words, it is going to be a very, very tight race this year between Central Houston and Stevens Creek for the number one sales crowd. This is a Sonic organization, and it gives you a sense, $25 million investment in the future and the belief in what Audi is bringing to this marketplace. And this is what's really going to galvanize and sustain the growth that you've been seeing. Now, for the products, just to be clear, as you know, we'll be launching next month the A3, 1.8 in front, and the 2-liter Quattro. In the fall, we'll be bringing the Cabriolet, S3, and the A3 TDI, so you get a sense of the variants, you get a sense of the drivetrains. Of course, in 2015, some of you had a chance to drive it at the LA Auto Show, we'll be bringing the A3 e-tron plug-in. This is the Sportback version of the A3, as you all know on that car. And then moving beyond, just the sedan, we have the A8 and SI product improvement. Coming on that front, we have the all-new Q3, as I mentioned, in the fall, and then the all-new TT coming as well. So the product portfolio that we have coming in the A segment with an SUV, with all the sedans, with the Sportback, gives us a lot of excitement over the next 2 years as we move into the marketplace.